Since 1893, a symbol of hockey supremacy.
It's the best known and hardest trophy to win in sports.
It is glorious, magnificent. The words don't really describe it.
Any stories with players, you know, taking it somewhere that's a little unique?
I can remember when Boston won, Zdeno Chara took it back to Trenčín, Slovakia, and it had been there a few times before. Marian Hossa had won it. Marian Gaborik went on to win it afterwards as well and brought it back to Trenčín also. They are all friends growing up, so they all go to one another's Stanley Cup party. When Zdeno finally won it, he was telling us about his day, and he goes, "We're going to end up at the Trenčín Castle." He goes, "You know the place. We go there every time." He goes, "But this time, I'm the host of it. I don't have to be a guest." And I just thought that was so special because that's the admiration that guys have one another. Although they didn't win it, they're celebrating their story. Philip Grubauer, a couple of years ago, Washington Capitals goalie, he is from the Bavarian Mountains outside of Munich, Germany. We went to his neighborhood, and it was halfway up the mountain. We hiked up to the top of the mountain in Bavaria, and we went for a traditional German breakfast. And I remember on the way back down, Philip's carrying it, and this herd of cows walks over. One of the cows sticks his head inside the bowl, and he's licking it. Whether you can taste the beer or something that was in there from breakfast, but a guy takes a cup out in a different way. Maybe it's not always a mountain, or maybe it's not always the Trenčín Castle, but in their hometown, it's their hometown, and that's what makes it special.
And speaking of mountains, I can picture the Niedermeyers up in the Canadian Rockies, right, with the cup. That's a great one, too.
The first time Scott took it up there, I was in the dressing room in New Jersey, and they were all crowded around Marty Brodeur and Scott Niedermeyer and asking what they're going to do for their day with the cup. Scott said, "I don't know, I'm just on top of the world right now." Little did anyone know he was going to take it to the top of the world. So he took it up there as a member of the New Jersey Devils, but then flash forward a few years when he wins with Anaheim, and Rob and Scott both go up the mountain with the cup this time. And I remember talking to them afterwards, and Scott says, "What an idiot Rob was. He picks a peak that two guys can't even stand on it. We have to crawl across another peak." Brotherly love.
Yeah.
And here they are trying to get a photo, but the peak wasn't wide enough for two guys to stand on it with a Stanley Cup. It's seen a lot of mountain ranges. It's seen a lot of different places around the world, and it's not done yet. It's only 129. It's got a long way to go.